Ukraine considering mobilizing 500,000 more soldiers to fight against Russia. President Volodymyr Zelensky said talks are ongoing to decide on the army's proposal. He adds an additional $13.5 billion would be needed to support the possible mobilization. Ukraine has been at war with Russian invaders since February 2022. Russia on Tuesday said it plans to add 1.5 million service members to its ranks. Heavy rain paralyzes several parts of India's Tamil Nadu, inundating roads, affecting train services and leaving authorities scrambling to rescue those stranded. The southern state received almost 50 millimeters of rainfall between Sunday and Monday, with more rainfall predicted. Local media reports at least five people died in the flooding and accidents related to the rains. The death toll in the powerful quake that hit China stands at 131. 16 others are missing. Rescuers now racing to search for survivors under the rubble amid sub-zero temperatures. Forecasters predict temperatures could dip to as low as negative 19 degrees Celsius in some areas affected by the quake over the next 3 days. The magnitude 6.2 quake struck northwest China just before midnight Monday. A landmark ruling in Colorado, the state Supreme Court bans former U.S. President Donald Trump from its 2024 ballot over his role in the 2021 Capitol attack. Now, this makes Trump the first presidential candidate in U.S. history deemed to be ineligible for the White House. The ruling cites a rarely used provision of the U.S. Constitution, barring officials who have engaged in insurrection or rebellion from holding office. The disruption in the Suez Canal will impact shipping costs, eventually leading to higher consumer prices. That warning from the head of trade logistics of the UN's trade body. Houthi attacks on ships in the Red Sea have prompted major shipping lines to reroute around Africa. Now, this means delays in deliveries and higher shipping costs. The UN official said container shipping rates have soared to their highest all year. The Red Sea is linked to the Mediterranean by the Suez Canal, which services about 12% of world shipping traffic.
So if you have systematically higher shipping costs for manufactured goods, the consumer goods that you and I buy in the shop, it takes many months to really translate into higher prices. But it will come. So if this situation continues, it will have a bearing also on the prices we pay in the shop for our consumer goods.
Meanwhile, some commercial vessels sailing through the Red Sea have announced they have armed guards on board. A number of container ships have also turned off tracking systems. Filipino culture and the end of the Hollywood strikes take center stage at this year's Comic-Con in Los Angeles. Our very own Steve Angeles tells us more.
From the cosplayers to creatives and Hollywood stars, Filipinos convened in a galaxy not so far away to get a piece of the action at the annual Los Angeles Comic-Con convention. This year's event drew about 123,000 people to the Los Angeles Convention Center to celebrate all things pop culture.
I think what really separates LA Comic-Con from like most other conventions I've attended is just the variety of fandom present. You got anime, you have Star Wars, you have fantasy, you got so many different fandoms like just present at LA Comic-Con. Like, not one fandom is dominating over the other. Like, it's just like everything all here.
It's our time. You know, it's way past where I thought we could be by now, but you know, more creative people are getting interested in helping each other and collaborating, and I think that's great.
I'm glad I got to see all like the different like comics and like the representations going on right now.
Filipino comic companies Lumpia, Dawada, and Dasing joined forces for the Holo Holo panel, sharing their journeys as comic creators fighting for Filipino representation.
I think it's great. I've been curious about more of my own culture lately. Seeing these creators, I just feel the tides are turning.
With the Hollywood strikes now over, the entertainment industry came out in force, with Filipino-American martial artist Diana Lee Inosanto joining the main stage as part of the Star Wars Ahsoka panel.
All I can say is I love you fans. You guys are amazing, and we appreciate all the love and support.
LA Comic Con celebrated more of the entertainment industry, giving fans a little more excitement compared to the lack of star power at the San Diego Comic Con International. For Irmer Tuana, whose TD Outpost specializes in Star Wars props, designs, and works with the actors, he's expecting to see more productions.
We're very excited. Congratulations to all our crew and staff and all of them that do the shows for us. We're very happy to see them back on board.
And with productions now ramping up, next year's circuit of comic conventions can expect more characters than before, and hopefully representing their Pinoy pride. Steve Anzos, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.
Filipino students win big at the World Robot Games in Taiwan. They hope their victory will put the spotlight on the transformative power of robotics. Izzy Lee tells us more.
The robotics elite team of DLSC and DLSAU celebrated their exceptional performance in the World Robot Games held in Taipei, Taiwan last month. The team secured an impressive haul of 65 medals, 3 trophies, and championship titles, outshining competitors from 5 countries. The team is being trained by coaches in coding, robot construction, and manipulation.
First, they were chosen from the robotics camp, and then they train yearly for every competition. So we prepare for each of the competition like months before the competition will be held. And the robotics coaches, they spend even Saturdays, Sundays, even the nighttime just to train the students.
A standout in the innovative category was the Dream House inspired by natural disasters in the Philippines.
And we aim to create a solution that addresses the sustainable development goals.
Ito pong flooding. Lalagay po siya ng water sa loob po ng mismong Dream House.
Pagkatapos po ng flood, may mag-i-inflate po sa ilalim po ng bahay para umangat po siya. Tapos mag-i-detach po siya sa kanyang sa lupa.
The Dream House, equipped to measure energy and simulate natural disasters, showcased innovative solutions, including an inflatable mechanism from flooding scenarios and seismic detection. Another remarkable entry in the innovative category was the Super Community.
We built this community so that people will use more renewable sources of energy and we can minimize the effects of climate change and protect our environment.
There's also this robot, which competed in the 1-minute game category.
Basically, the point of this game is to pull the cans as much as we can during a 1-minute time span of 1 minute, and whoever moves as much cans during that 1 minute will win the game.
In the Sumo Bot 1K category, a robot was introduced strategically equipped with sensors to outmaneuver opponents within the ring.
This is called the scooper. This is what's used to push out your opponent's robot. Then we also have distance sensors, so our robot is able to see the opponents from the front and the sides. We also have the brain.
But beyond the medals and trophies, the school underscores the commitment to preparing students for future career goals.
This is part of the 21st century skills that will be used by our students. It's not only for education purposes, but also for their life goals. If ever they would like to enter engineering courses or any coding courses, then they are already starting at a younger age, as early as grade school.
Easily, ABS-CBN News.
Here's a billion reasons to look forward to 2024. The Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office is launching a new lottery game next year with a minimum jackpot prize of 1 billion pesos. No word yet on when exactly this new game will be launched. But the PCSO said it will be partnered after or make that patterned after a popular lottery game in the U.S.
Magpapa base price po na 1 billion. Gagawin po natin yan. Next year po, we will pattern it after the Powerball sa US. It's a different jackpot game.
Well, Hamas rejects talks for another hostage prisoners swap deal with Israel, but it says it remains open to any initiative that would help end the war. The group insists negotiations will not happen under what it called Israel's genocidal war. It also slams the U.S. for its continued support of Israel.
For 74 days, the Israeli war machine has been destroying entire neighborhoods and civilian infrastructure, not to mention the mass killing of our people everywhere, including in their homes, in hospitals, or in shelters. We affirm our position of categorically rejecting to hold any form of negotiations over prisoners exchange under the continuing Israeli genocidal war. We are, however, open to any initiatives that contributes to ending the aggression on our people and opening the crossing to bring in aid and provide the relief to our Palestinian people.
Israel's president earlier signaled the country is ready to enter another truce in order to save more hostages held by Hamas. Tense negotiations continue at the United Nations over a draft resolution on the Israel-Hamas war. The UN Security Council is avoiding another veto from the U.S. to pass a resolution drafted by the United Arab Emirates, which aims to allow more aid to enter Gaza. It also seeks a monitoring of the humanitarian assistance being delivered into the enclave.
We are now coming to the end of what was the deadliest year in the occupied Palestinian territory. This should be a wake-up call that the current status quo cannot be allowed to continue. 2.2 million people remain trapped, with 9 out of every 10 spending entire days without food. Gazans are experiencing unprecedented levels of starvation and thirst, while doctors lack even the most basic of medical supplies to treat the wounded and the growing threat of infection. What we need is access. Israel must stop blocking the entry of aid and allow life-saving assistance into the Gaza Strip.
As for the U.S., it says it continues to work with other U.N. Security Council members to resolve outstanding issues on the draft resolution. The White House says Washington fully supports addressing the humanitarian needs of Palestinians, but it insists details of the text matter. The U.S. wants to tone down the language of the resolution. An initial draft called for an urgent and lasting cessation of hostilities to allow unimpeded access of humanitarian aid to the Gaza Strip. But sources say it has been watered down to an urgent suspension of hostilities to satisfy Washington. One of the Filipinos taken hostage by Hamas recounts his ordeal during his nearly 50 days in captivity. Jimmy Pacheco says he was among the hostages paraded in Gaza. That moment was captured in a viral video of him tied in the back seat of a pickup truck.
Ang sabi ko sa isang general nila kasi nakausap ko, bakit niyo kami dinala dito? May mga Thailander at mga Pilipino kami. Isa lang yung sagot niya, it's a big mistake. Hindi na nagsalita. Hindi mo alam kung kailan ka mamamatay kasi talagang yanig yung tunnel eh, kapag ano eh, nagbubumbahan. Eh. Nung nasa tunnel kami, mga third week or fourth week, mga ganun na. Pag magdasal na ako noon, inahamon ko na rin yung Diyos eh. Kapag may pikot ko na to, ako sa kanya, sana wag mo na lang akong gisingin. Ganun na yung mga dasal ko noon. Para tapos na yung paghihirap ko.
Pacheco is now back home to spend the Christmas holidays with his family despite his ordeal. Jimmy says he still plans to continue working in Israel.